everyone, it's Jen from Acclaim Fitness, and today I have another athletic training, number 10. Just like a mishmash of some moves, it will definitely help with your athleticism. We're gonna do some jump ropes to start and finish. We have our high elevation box jumps. I think I'm gonna be using lower, yes, absolutely. Barbell for some things, kettlebells, dumbbells, the usual band. I do have a band for some moves, and I had it latched on here, sort of like mid height, and I believe that's it. So we're going to start with a warm-up. This is going to be two rounds. We're going to do a full minute of jump rope, just two rounds, and then we're going to go into 30 seconds of full release push-ups to get our upper body warmed up, and then we're just going to do full reverse lunges. So we'll do one leg touching the ground, getting that nice stretch. That's our warm-up. So let's start to get your jump rope ready. We're going to go in 10 seconds. So if I'm moving forwards, because I want to make sure I have space and I don't hit my barbell. All right, we're going to start in 5 seconds. I don't touch the ceiling either. So just to get our wrists warmed up, our calves, getting our heart ready. A little bit of cardio, a little bit of core, a little bit of power. So hopefully helps with every aspect of your athleticism. Even if you don't play sports, you know, I'm 50, so I'm not competing for anything, but I like to stay in good shape. Well-rounded. I want to be like well-rounded in what I can do, so I don't stick to one thing. So we have 20 seconds. Then you're gonna go right in your full release. I'll probably just do it a little close to the ground. I know my elevation's sort of in the way. We're just gonna be in the high elevation for the first set. 7 seconds. Always think it's important to have nice calves warmed up. Full release. Do a little Superman and come up. Pickleball is such a big thing. It has been for like a couple of years, and people I know that play, and it's very fun, but they tend to go out and play hard and tear. It's always like a calf or Achilles like tear on our lunges. It's because they're not warming up their calves. So I'm going to reverse with my right, left stable all the way down. We're going to go right back to jump rope. So very, very quick 4 minute warm up, and we're hitting some 5x5s. I think I have 2 5x5s in here, yeah. I'm gonna grab that jump rope. Another minute. Last time. Box jumps, clean and press is 5x5. You can do barbell, dumbbell, kettlebell, whatever you want to do for your clean and press. So now I can actually mix it up between barbell and dumbbells. You have 20 seconds. One more round of release and reverse lunge the other leg. Focus, and then we have lunges. All right, other leg. Forward, fold down. So superset 5x5. And then you're done with your warm up. So similar to anchor band. I think there's only two moves. So here we go, no timer needed. 5x5, box jumps, clean and press. Add 24 inches, 1, 2, 3. One more. 75 on the bar. All right, that's it, box jumps. Dumbbells. I'm gonna do 30s. One, 2, 3. One more. Full body. Round three, so really, really cool. 5x5. So my heart rate's up. Here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Barbell again. Whew. 1, 2, 3. Round 4. Oh, coming up. One, 2, 3, 4, and 5. These are my dumbbells. I feel like kettlebells. I can do it, but it's a little awkward. One. Two. Three. Four. And five. We have one more round. That we're not going to hit. I'll move my elevation out of the way. 1, 2, 3, 4. And all right, I'm going to try one more time. Hit the barbell. Why not challenge ourselves? two, three, one more. And five. All right, crank it up. We have a 30, 10. We're gonna do this four times through because we're gonna alternate sides. So your first move is a single arm mountain climber. So you're gonna single arm and you're just gonna mountain climb. All right, we'll switch rounds on that. You can do it elevated if that feels more comfortable for you. Ooh, then we have our hinged band of rotation. And so what you're gonna do is you're gonna come out, you have to make sure there's no slack in your band. Well, you'll come out, obviously I'm gonna alternate, so you'll see my behind for a while, but you're gonna grab your band, just make it comfortable, and almost like you're hinging a little bit, and almost like you're swinging. All right, so working the core and rotation. Then we're gonna do a lunge squat and press. I'm gonna use a 25, so you're gonna lunge, squat, press, and just stick to one side. And then we're gonna finish with the twist around the world. I got a 40 for that. Because you're gonna do a 180 twist, then bring it around the world and repeat, okay? All right, four rounds, this is long. 30 seconds are quick though, okay? So we're gonna start, count down 5 seconds. I think those single arm mountain climbers would be easy, but I'm not. So I'm gonna start with my left. So I'll start left on everything. I think that's, well, I guess that's not true, but hinging and pressing this way first, just so I'm facing you. So try your best. Use your arm, okay? Focus. We have that hinge next. I'm already sweating. Round two. So hinge. Slow and controlled. 15 seconds. Grab a single dumbbell next. I'm gonna lunge to my left. Lunge, squat, and press. Last woo, twist. Make this dynamic and powerful. Around. Back to the start. When we're done, this single arm mountain climbers, other arm. I'm gonna do my right. Double arm. It's a good thing I didn't do 50 seconds. Keep that core tight. Focus. And the rotations are again coming up. Pick the speed you want to go or that you feel comfortable with. All right. Nice and easy. 10 seconds, clean and press. Other side, clean squat press. Lunge. I don't want to like confuse you, it's a lunge too. Back to my 25s. Lunge into your squat. I'm gonna actually try 30s next round. And press. Three seconds. Alright, twist, twist. Ooh, almost done round two. Moving fast. Longest hit set. Yes, it is. Give it another 5x5 though. I'm not trying to jump. Just letting you know. We'll take a break from the hit and do reps. And that one's all kettlebells. Alright, back to our single arm. Left, mountain climber. This set has it all, okay? Focus. Band your rotations. Make sure you create that good resistance, okay? No slack. You can make it more powerful by like going fast and slow. Seconds. Lunge. Clean squat. Okay, so let's try 30. It's only 30 seconds. Lunge. Clean. Press. Gotta challenge yourself. And if you feel good today, pick up those weights. Twist. Twist, twist. Around the world. This is a fun one. Round your body. Keep it tight. A lot of obliques up here. Wait, one more round. Control. Own that weight. Alright, one. Single arm out there. Last time. On the right.
coming out. Different, we're going to slingshot front lunge. So, here, sit down. Dynamic. You'll start from setting it down. You're always going to keep it up in the air, five on each leg. Then we're going to do box squats. Deadlift box squat clean. We're going to do that. I'm going to use a 50 for that. Right is going to grab, my left's going to lunge forward. I'm going to catch. One. Two. Three. If you don't like it, you can catch first and then lunge. Four. It takes a while to get used to this, okay? We're so used to going backwards, which is obviously safer for your knees, so if you feel more comfortable with that, go for it. Muscle memory. Okay, so it's like the next time you do these, your body knows them. Three, four, and five. Set it down carefully. And we got our deadlift. So you actually deadlift down, sit with no weight, and then pop up clean it to clean. Okay, so grabbing it. Then you sit, then you clean. One, two, core tight. Three, four, and five. I'm going to go heavier on those. Hard to hold on to, but I can try it. Maybe I'll try it like towards the end. We'll see. All right, swing front lunge. It's more of a slingshot. One, two. You're holding the handle a little bit different. Two, three, four, and five. I'm just gonna do a swing switch. Two, three, four, one more. One. Two. Three. Four. And five.
Right, round three.
Oh, hi, hurry. One, two, three, four, and five. Swing, switch. One, two, three, four, and five. Right. Round three. I'm always like, all right, all right. I can say that a lot. One. Power it up. Squeeze the glutes. Two. Three. Work those muscles. Think of the muscles you're using. So important. Makes such a difference. Round four. Two more rounds. You know, you write these workouts and you're like, should be okay. This one's good. This set is hard. On paper, it didn't feel like that way. One, two, three, four, and swing switch. Go right into it. One, two, three, four, and sit down. Control. Don't get lazy. One, two, three.
I will try my bigger bell. It might be awkward though, we'll see.
Don't laugh. One more.
The handle's like so big. And you know, like, it's probably good for a male, just the bell, so there's somewhat bigger hands. More round.
One, two, three, four, and five.
Swing, switch. Last time.
One. Might notice one side stronger. Two. One more comfortable. Three. Four. And five. Not sure if I need my 40 again, but I want to take the side. Alright, let's work. 65 pounds technically. It says 60, but it's 65. Grab it. Rest it all the way down on that hinge. One. Two. It's only five reps, right? That's a grab really hard. Three. That's all they don't slip. Four. out of the way. We have a Tabata HIIT set. So Tabata format, and then it's 20 seconds on, 10 seconds rest. Ooh, my heart rate's up. All right, so we're gonna do chopped overhead press. So you're kind of in a staggered position. You're gonna chop, switch hands, press, chop. Since it's four times, we're gonna alternate. We're doing that four times, then we go on to the next move. And the next move is a banded dead bug. So I'm gonna get on my back. My feet are gonna be bent. I'm gonna hold that band straight up. And I'm gonna drop my legs. I can show you, but I'm still trying to catch my breath. Then we have bear hold commando. So you're gonna be bear position. You're gonna do up, down, down, up, up, plank hop in and out, or actually out and into bear. Four times, and then we have a sit-up press. Four times. Single dumbbell, probably just use like a 25, I hope. I think. All right, this is an 8-minute set. So 16 rounds, all right? Starting with that, I already forgot. Chopped overhead press, 25. So I'm gonna use 125 for actually this whole move, like a whole set. Yeah, because that's body weight. Woohoo! 10 seconds, chop, staggered position. So my right's back for this round and my left is forward. 5 seconds. So we're doing that chop, switch, press, chop, chop. We'll alternate. Chops the next round. Use that core. So I'll stagger and chop this way and then press. I don't know why I had it the other way. 5-4. So you're gonna chop. Yeah, that sounds better. Or feels better. I don't know why this is the other way. Almost done with this move. One more round. All right, then we have those banded dead bugs. So legs will drop, holding that. Make sure good with the resistance. Stagger. You have good resistance, okay? So hold it up, and you're just gonna drop. I'm gonna need to move some stuff. But hold the band, arms straight, and lower the legs. So you're getting upper and lower. And what we could do, if you wanna make it harder, do one leg, and then the other leg. Let me move some of this stuff out of the way. Or you can put like a medicine ball between your knees and drop both of them at the same time. Alright, we have two more rounds. Oh, and then we have that commando bear plank hops. Controlled. Use the abs. Legs, like shins are the last thing to get sweaty. So if they're sweaty, you're really releasing a lot of toxins. One more round. And you're popping up for another body weight move. So bring those arms out, knees up. This is a nice little, I don't want to say recovery because you can still feel that fire in the 5 seconds. Two rounds on the ground at 25. Four rounds and start sit-ups. Press. 2 minutes. Maybe a little combo pyramid coming up. We got this. Going in 4. Recovery. It's important. Trained your heart really well. Making it stronger. One more round. 20 seconds left in this set. We have 3 pyramid sets, 5 to 1, pairs, you'll see. I will be using my barbell for the first one. I'll keep it at 75. I could probably go heavier, but I'll just focus on form. You can always somewhat make something feel a little bit heavier. Just really, really engage everything. Recover. So we will also do our elevation. So we're going to start with a deadlift. So actually rollouts and then deadlifts. So you'll do 5 rollouts into 5 deadlifts. 4, 3, 2, 1. Super quick this one. All right, so you come down, roll it out. 1.2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, one. You have to keep things fun. It can't be like dreadful of a workout, at least for me. Otherwise, you don't want to do it anymore. Two. So you gotta do what you love. All right. The best workout is the one that you. I guess the best workout is the one you did, or the one you like. Doesn't matter. As long as you keep going. Forget if I just did two. One rep. And one. All right. And rack it. All right, we're on to clean and a step up. So I'm gonna do one leg at a time here. I'm gonna use my 40. So I'm just gonna clean it. When I'm not gonna do a normal clean, I'm gonna clean, catch. And I'll step up my left, I think that's what makes sense. One, two, three, four, and five. One, two, three, four, and five. One to four. Same line. One. Power it up. Two. Three. You can do dumbbells too. You do two dumbbells. One. Two. Three. And four. One to three. One. Two. Down, recover, other side, one more leg. All right. One. But I actually enjoy step-ups. Oh, I did this wrong. And five, I did it totally wrong. All right, so now I'm just gonna do my four cleans and four step-ups. I'm like in that groove. Right. Four and four. One, two, three. Two reps. One, two, one, and two. One rep. One, and one. Set it down. We have push-ups. We're gonna do squat swings. So five push-ups, then you're gonna come up and you're gonna ski squat swing overhead. I'm just gonna do 20s. Hopefully this one goes fast. overhead. One, two, three, four, and five. Four reps. Carefully lower. One, two, three, and four. One, two, three, and four. Three. One, two, three. One, two, and three. Two reps. One, two, one. Last one. And carefully come up. Recover. My heart is up. All right. All right, so we have another, just a couple rounds. We have another hit set coming up. We're actually just gonna do a pyramid hit. Okay, so two moves. We're gonna do hip to hip halo. So hip, halo, hip. I want you to rotate a little bit. I'm gonna use one single 25 for that. And then we're gonna do skaters with a single arm swing. So three skaters, a little dynamic, okay, but this one's fun. So maybe go out wide, single arm swing. 6 minutes, all right. We're getting close to the end. Timer goes up, timer goes down. Starting with that hip to hip halo. Okay. So it's like hip. So you can bring your toes up around the head. Halo around the head. Nice hip rotation. A little bit, you know, getting the hips there. Skaters and a single arm swing. Hopefully you can see this. Problem is my walls are only so far. Maybe my camera, I'm using my iPad. So one, two, three, stagger. Swing, set down. One, two, three. This is a 30 second round. Set down. One, two, and then kind of close. Back to our halo. Hip, hip. Woo! Hip, hip, hooray! Make it like athletic, okay? This is a 40 second round. Seconds of skaters. One, two, three. One, two, three. Just be aware of where your kettlebell is. One, two, two. One. Leap. Laterally. Very good. Very important. With your athleticism. 3 seconds. Hip, hip, parallel. 50 seconds. Jump rope to finish, okay? So a little cardio finisher. So you know you're almost done. Reps though, not timed. Get those lats, you should feel that. 10 seconds. Skaters. Should be still smiling, okay? This is fun stuff. And you feel good. You didn't even realize you're actually like working out. That's what I want this workout to feel like. Just having so much fun, you forget that this is hard work. All right, one more round. Reach. 13, 20. Cardio finisher, rest will go down, okay? Make sure you're in good position for the swing, having that hip hinge. So don't swing until you're ready. Set it down. All right, we have 3 moves. Jump rope's the first one. That'll be 100 to 20, dropping by 20 reps each round. Then we're gonna do swings and then squat jumps. That's it, all right? I'm gonna try and use my heavier kettlebell and your squat jumps, obviously just body weight. Dropping by 2 reps because we're gonna go from 10 to 2, okay? This is just a nice little finisher, kind of rounding out the workout, ending where we started. Posterior, 10, sit down, 10 squat jumps. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 8, 80, and 80. Four more rounds. Oh, hit my head. I think I hit the barbell. 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 4, 3, 2, 1. All right, 8, and 8. Try and recover. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. 8 sponge jumps. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. On to 60. Don't lose it, all right? Keep it going. Then slow it down. Don't think about it. 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60. All right. So move quick. One, two, three, four, five, and six. One, two, three, four, five, and six. We got 40. So we're so close, it's gonna go fast. Keep up. Make sure to stretch after this. 1, 2, 3, 4. You really have to feel your body connection with those swings. That posterior, okay? Just connect. This is it. Movement so quick, it's like you don't want to lose the focus. 20. 10. 20, 2 and 2. So quick, this finisher. 1 and 2. Didn't you have fun? And 2. A little mishmash, like I said. So I'm going to try and let my heart come down. So cool down, stretch. All right, very important. Drink lots of water. Ooh, let that heart rate come down first. But your body's warm, that's time to stretch. Hope you enjoyed this workout. Hope you come back for more. There were 10 of these athletic training workouts. So I will see you next time. Thanks for joining in.